What's up, Plane Crash Survivors? This is KJ48, and welcome back to my Let's Play of The Forest. This is Alpha 0.35, Season 11, Episode 2, and I've been doing some grinding here off camera. I got a bunch of sticks and made all these log sleds. I also got a bunch of stones, made some of these stone boulder holder things, made some stick holders. What else? Oh yeah, I put down this platform. This is going to be the beginning of my house. I'm not sure. It might be a little big. I'm debating on whether I want to make a smaller one, but I don't know. I guess that's pretty good. I got a better idea. Let's take this down. I'm gonna make a smaller one, and I'm gonna make platforms going to. I want to do something a little different. I always make the big, huge building like area like that, and then I just build on it. I'd like to make smaller building areas and maybe go to other building areas. I don't know. So I think the first building area we're going to make is going to be our actual sleeping quarters slash house. And I could also show you how I built that so straight. So basically, I'm going to come over here. We're going to make this relatively small. This will be where I sleep. That one doesn't really matter how you do it. This one's going to be a little bit more. I'm trying to think how I want to do this. I do want a little bit of a deck. And then let me think how I'm going to build. I could build that way. Yeah, the deck is going to be in front. Back here is going to be where I actually sleep. I think that's probably pretty good. This is really hard to tell, how big you want to make these things. This is why I usually do this placing off camera, because it's a little tricky to do this right. But for this first one, I'm going to do it on camera, just so I could show you, how I do it, and, see how tricky it is. You come over here. I'm not really sure. I think that is straight. That looks pretty straight to me. Then we gotta come over here. Yeah, make it a lot smaller. Alright, so this one's gotta come over here. Well, that can go wherever, it doesn't matter. Well, it does matter, we need to make it. Well, no, actually it doesn't, we can make it as... Looks pretty good. Is that straight? Oh yeah, that's pretty straight. And then you come over here and you put it right back where you started. Try and get it right on where you started. Alright, let's see what that looks like. Yeah, that looks pretty straight to me. So what I'm going to do is this first part right here is going to be a deck, and that will go off to other buildings, and behind it will be where I sleep. And, the deck, what I could do is I could make the deck, go off into another part of the building, and then, there's all different kinds of ways I could do it. Basically, to make each part of my buildings, one section. It's going to be very modular. Yeah, so what we need to do now is we need to cut down a lot of trees, but we don't cut down trees because cutting down trees is how poor man gets stuff, and we're not poor. We're going to actually go on a little bit of a loot run today, and what we're going to do is first thing we're going to do is eat. We need something to drink, so we're going to come on over here and drink out of this water here. It's not the healthiest way to do it, but, what are you going to do? It will make us cough and splutter, and I'm not really sure what it does to us, if it hurts us or anything, but... whatever. So over this way, there is a cannibal camp. It is the main cannibal camp I like to go to. And it's a really, really cool cannibal camp because you can pretty much get everything you need there. And the main things I'm going to need is dynamite and cloth. I'm going to need a lot of cloth. A lot of cloth. If you guys have been watching the multiplayer series I do with Game Edge, you'll know why we need a lot of cloth. It's used for two things. It's used for all fighting, because I use it to light cannibals on fire. And it's also used for bone armor, which is the best armor in the game. So, we gotta find it first, though. It's a little bit tricky to find the first couple times I look for it. But, I'll get it. There's another cannibal camp here. Hopefully there won't be anybody here. We'll just run by. And, we're going to save our stamina a little bit in case we have to make a run for it. There is some cloth in here as well. There's a couple suitcase we can hit. We're not going to hit them. I actually hit a suitcase in between videos, and then I realized I'm holding all the watches I can. Now, watches are really important to the game because they're using to make bombs. And, I kind of want to save my watches. Over here is where Game Edge and I are building on the multiplayer series. Give you a little tour. And if you're new to this game, honestly, this is probably the best place I've ever built. Well, over here somewhere, I don't know. Maybe it's over there. I don't know, I think I passed it. But, if you look on the multiplayer series, that's the best place I've ever built. It's a really good place. Although, we do have a lot of cannibals coming. We're thinking that The reason the cannibals are attacking us so often is because of bonfires. So, yeah, we're building bonfires and we get attacked constantly. It might also have something to do with the fact that it's multiplayer. We don't really know. All we know is that, like, it's a barrage, a relentless barrage. And I'm eventually get we have a defense on that server called the Circle of Protect. The fuck was that? Right, never mind. Called the Circle of Protection. It's basically happy birthday traps in a circle, where you just stand in the middle and you let the cannibals kill themselves on the happy birthday traps. Now, a lot of people have been asking me to use different traps than happy birthday traps. They want to see the different traps. I'm just going to let you know right now that in my experience with the traps is they're all shit, except for the happy birthday traps. The happy birthday traps, the only traps I've had any success with constantly, and they're the best trap. I will use the happy birthday traps with the circle of protection, but because you asked me, I will use other traps as well, you know, in other areas, and we'll look at some other traps as well, just because you guys asked me to, since you asked me nicely. All right, so we're gonna build a little marker here, and this is for the cannibal camp. We will turn this, yeah, kind of red, I guess, and then that way we can get back here at any time. All right, so here is the cannibal camp. This is my stop and shop. Oh boy, we got some guys here. All right, this is my stop and shop. This is my, you know, my Walmart, whatever. This is where I come for my stuff. See, you light them on fire. And you just beat the hell out of them. Till they don't move no more. And the other guy ran away. So we're going to leave him right there. If we kill any other of them, we'll stack up their bodies and burn them for bones. But as of right now, you know, lighting one guy on fire really isn't that important. You want to grab the circuit boards because you're going to need these for bombs as well. The one thing I'm missing for bombs is right now is change, and I'll show you how to get change at some point. Maybe not today, but here's the dynamite. Well, if you want to know how to get change, you basically just go to the beach and you take a stick and you beat the sand with the stick, and it'll eventually dig you up some change. All right, we got a lot of sodas there. Sodas are really good. We got the dynamite, we got the sodas, now let's grab some rope and some cloth. You can hold up to 10 sodas, so make sure you got your, you know, stocked with sodas when you leave here. There we go. Again, I'm not going to open up any of these cases until I get... Hold on. Don't mess with me, bro. I'm telling you. You don't want none of this. You don't want none of this bad medicine. Alright, you know what? You're pissing me off now. You done fucked up. Alright, now we're gonna have a barbecue. Now we're gonna have a corpse barbecue, you punk asses. I told you to leave me alone. I didn't want no trouble. You kidnapped my kid, I'm willing to forgive. But now you just can't leave well enough alone. Where was that other body? Crap, I don't remember. Over here? Oh, damn it. Where was it? I thought it was over here somewhere. I know it was by a tree. Oh well, the hell with it. I know I was probably really close today. I know you guys probably saw it, I apologize, but I'm not gonna take a ton of time looking for it. We'll just burn these two dumbasses. Now, to burn a corpse, in case you didn't see me do it last episode, you light up the axe. And you wait until a bird comes along. Yeah, screw it. Sometimes I wait for a bird to come along. I don't need that. Birds are good for feathers, by the way. So we definitely want to get some feathers. How did I miss him? I'm gonna get you. Oh, come on. Hacks. There you go. Come on. Come on. Alright, I'm not going to get that one. Alright, let's get some more cloth. That's what we came here for. Oh, bird. As soon as you're going to hit the bird, just start spamming the E button. You'll pick up a lot of feathers, you know. Alright. Alright, there we go. The bones. Alright, now while you're cleaning up those bones, you go ahead and you make some more. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. More bone armor. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Very good. Alright, let's get some more cloth. Cloth is my lifeblood. I use it for the... Like I said it before, I'm going to say it again. I use it for my defense, and I use it for the fires, which are my offense. Damn it. It's really hard to get those feathers. Good thing there's lots of birds. There we go. 9, 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a stick. Arrows. I know we don't have a bow yet. We'll get a bow. Don't worry about it. We have everything we need for the bow. Alright. More cloth. I'll probably make a run up here once every recording session. But if it gets boring, then I'll just stop showing it. Oh, this guy's got a bunch of tennis balls in his guts. That's messed up, dude. That's messed up. I gotta say, I don't like these cannibals. I've mentioned this in past seasons that, you know, the cannibals in this game are some of the enemies that I really dislike greatly, to the point where I'm angry at them. Like, I'm literally angry with them. You know, I'm not angry at this 7 Days to Die zombies. I'm not angry at, you know, whatever in any other game I'm playing. But in this game, I don't know why. The cannibals just really piss me off. I just don't know. Maybe because they're sick. You know, they're freaking dismembering bodies like a bunch of freaks. Although I guess I do as well. But I don't eat bodies. And besides, here's the difference. They're dismembering innocent people. You know, these are just people who crashed on a plane. You know, when I dismember a body of the cannibal, those are the people who dismembered the people that crashed on the plane. So I'm kind of like a hero. Not kind of a hero. I am a hero. I'm the greatest hero in the history of the world. All right, maybe that's a little bit much, but you get what I'm saying. Like, these are evil, sadistic sons of bitches. They need to be ended. They should not be on the planet. I will not suffer them living on my planet any longer. Let's grab some sticks here really quick. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a rope and a stick. And another rope. No. Do we need 2 sticks for that? We need cloth, don't we? No. What do we need for the bow? It wasn't 2 sticks, was it? Maybe tree sap? I don't remember. I'm sure you guys let me know in the comments. 2 sticks, a rope, cloth. Oh, there it is. Got it. How much cloth do I have? 41? It's pretty good. Let's get out of here. Let's get back home. Okay, I'm making a little detour here on the beach. Because I'm going to be looking for some turtles. I'm also going to be showing you guys how to get change on the beach, like I mentioned earlier. Also, maybe some birds. Freaking birds. Okay, so what you're gonna do if you want to get change on the beach is you grab yourself a stick and you left click into this sand. Sometimes you'll get nothing, sometimes you'll get a rock, and sometimes you'll get change. Okay. Yep, there's a rock. Keep a lookout for turtles while we're doing this. This is the main reason we're here. We're gonna get turtle shells and make ourselves a rain catch. That way we could drink, you know, good water instead of the water out of the pond. Which apparently is bad for us. Change usually doesn't take this long. I don't know. Weird. I usually would have gotten some change by now. There we go. All right, so what you do with the change is you grab the change, the watch, the booze, and a circuit board, and boom, you got a bomb. You can also put a tree sap on it and make it a sticky bomb, so that way when you throw it, it doesn't bounce around. It stays where you threw it. So, I suggest you use the sticky bombs. There's a turtle. Say goodnight. Alright. Let's try and get a little bit more change. And then we'll head back. Come on, give me one more thing of change. Come on. Please. Oh, what was that? Change. Sweet. Watch change, booze, circuit board. These little generic meats, I think, are from the birds. And I think you have to cook them on a fire. Yeah, you have to cook on a fire, so. Alright, sticky bomb. How much tree sap do I have? 13. That's not a lot. Alright, let's start heading home now. Starting to get a little dark. I don't like being out during the dark. It gets scary. And I don't like it. I start getting worried, nervous, scared, wet pants, you know, stuff like that. I hate those little stupid small rocks. They're annoying. Alright, let's go this way. Want to avoid that camp right there. Oh, wait, never mind. That's my camp. I don't want to avoid that camp. Man, we're really close to the beach. I didn't realize how close we were to the beach. Alright, I do want you guys to be able to see at night, but I don't know if I'm ready to make a bonfire yet. I guess I probably could. The problem making a bonfire, though, is it's really going to bring the evil sons of bitches my way. I got to figure out where I'm going to make my circle of protection. Circle of protection. We don't have a lot of room over here for it. I could always make it around this. It would be pretty small, though. But I could make it around my my treehouse. Yeah, for sure. So what do we want the bonfire? It's getting dark. Ugh. Maybe we could sleep through the night. Oh, the timer's set, so yeah, we could sleep through the night once it's dark. Alright, let's go ahead and make our, let's go ahead and make the rain catch. First things first, make the rain catch. I know this is dark, I'm sorry, let me get out my... The darkness is not going to be a problem in the future, I will be taking care of it in the future. Alright, rain catch. Yeah, passed it. Rain catch. Rain catch. There it is. Water collector. I'll be done in a minute. Okay. Water collector. There we go. And now anytime it rains, we'll collect some water. So we don't have to keep drinking that disgusting pond water. Alright. So should we make this circle of protection here? See, these things are going to get in the way. That's going to be the problem. We can't really make it here. And I don't want to make it over here because I'm going to be making this... this building over here, so I don't know what I want to do. See, I want a way to kill them. I could just stay up in my treehouse, but if I'm in the middle of a video and I can't leave my treehouse, then I can't kill them. That could be a problem. We do need some kind of wall system. I need to know where I'm going to be building out, though. I'm going to be definitely building out this way, and probably this way. So definitely, I could make it over. No, I don't want to make it over there. I don't know where I want to make it, guys. Maybe up here. I guess this would be a good spot for the circle of protection. It's a little bit out of the way, though. And don't forget, I am going to be making this circle of protection with traps. So, with that being said, we can... Yeah. You know what? We're going to make the circle of protection up here. We're not going to do it tonight because we're running out of time. And we're actually, you know... We're simply running out of time, and yeah, we can't do that. I don't want to make the bonfires down here, though, because I am in a spot where if I make bonfires, then the enemy will come get me sooner rather than later, and I don't want to do that. So let's just make some regular skull lamps. The cool, like, the skull lamps do not give you anywhere near as much, like, light radius as anything else, pretty much. But the thing is, they're, they stay on forever. And they will give you guys some kind of light radius. So, I'd like you guys to be able to see. There. And there for now. Nope, not there. Take this one down. And let's go grab some sticks here. Again, sorry about the darkness. I'm gonna do what I... And you know what? I could always brighten this up in post. The problem is a lot of times when I'm like rendering the video, I don't think about brightening it up and then I'll forget. So I don't really like to rely on brightening it up in, when editing. There we go. And one more set. Those trees right... Those little trees right there give you the most sticks. Not enough tree sap, of course. All right, so how good is that? That's pretty decent. It's a little good. So I'll make the circle of protection up there. I'll make the bonfire up there. I'm not going to make the bonfire until the circle of protection is done. I'm not going to make anything any bonfires until the circle of protection is done, which means we're going to have to definitely cut out the knights, which means we're going to have to cut this one a little bit early. So we'll call this one here. That'll be it for episode 2, and we will see you next time for episode 3. Till then, take it easy.